Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, December 18th, we'll remember the fact, the truth, that Jesus came as God's gift to us, to the mankind. In 2 Corinthians 9:15, Paul says, "Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift." The gift that we got from God is indescribable. With our human language, with our human brains, we can't describe him. We can't understand him also properly. And so we have to depend upon the Holy Spirit to teach us what all it means. Jesus is God's gift for the mankind. We are blessed by this gift since Jesus gave himself as a sacrifice to pacify God's anger. What is this? Proverbs 21:14 says, "A gift pacifies anger." Why is God angry with us, and where was the need to pacify him? In Romans 2:5, Paul says, In accordance with your hardness and your impertinent heart, you're treasuring up for yourself wrath in the day of wrath and revelation of the righteous judgment of God. We are not repenting for all our sins that we are committing, and the merciful God is angry to note the hardness of our hearts. God loved us so much that he gave his only son to redeem us. But still, we are not able to understand the love and depth of his sacrifice. Every sin that we are committing is lightening. It's igniting his wrath. It's making it more. The only way to pacify his anger is through Jesus Christ. There is no other way. What does a gift do? According to Proverbs 18:16, a man's gift makes room for him and brings him before great men. Jesus' gift of himself as a sacrifice to God is the most precious gift which was able to reconcile us with God and make a way for us to go into God's presence. Actually, hope you are understanding what I'm saying. Jesus Christ was given to us as a gift from God, and the same gift we offered to him as a sacrifice. What a shame, actually. But still, there was no other way for redeeming us. So he gave himself up for us. 1 Peter 3:18 says that Jesus suffered for our sins so that he might bring us to God. On the cross, Jesus took hold of the hand of a sinner in one hand, and with the other bleeding hand, he caught hold of his Father's hand and made them one. Like this, he's holding our hands at one end and God's hand at the other end. So that is how he could make us come together. What a nice understanding this is. He stood between God's wrath and man's sin. We are all enemies of God because of our sin and disobedience. We are making him angry, but Jesus is pacifying him, first by dying on the cross and now by continuously pleading for us. We have to be grateful to him always, thanking him always. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for what all you did for us. Please help us to recognize the great sacrifice that you made for us and be grateful to you always. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen. Amen. God bless you.